Trauma, boundaries, and the body. What's the connection between experiences that we've gone through, trauma, or experiences that we've gone through throughout our lifetime and relationships we've experienced, boundaries, the way that we have boundaries today, the ways that we interact with the world, and our body. So I wrote a recent article that just explains the connections between how we develop these nonverbal cues that let people know what our boundaries are or are not, and then different kinds of boundaries that people have. Is it rigid? Is it secure? Is it more permeable and undifferentiated? You can read more about that in the link below. But I just wanted to hop on and give you four pointers to help you get clearer about setting better boundaries and really allowing yourself to live a richer life and getting more out of the relationships and experiences you're having right now. So the first question I would ask you to ask yourself is, we know that we all carry beliefs in the way that in our minds, but also in our bodies. And the beliefs that we carry really impact how we show up to the world. So number one I would ask is, what are the beliefs that I'm carrying on my mind and my body? I'm confident, I'm skilled, I'm not worthy, I'm not smart, I'm incapable, I'm unlovable. Like, what are the beliefs that you're carrying? And are they really true? Right? So maybe at one point it was true that you struggled with something. Is it still true today? Because if it's not, then I want you to let that go. Or is it borrowed from somebody else? Is this a belief that somebody told you and you took it on, but it might not be true? And then you also, it's time for you to let that go. The second thing is, am I practicing presence in my connections with people? So sometimes we show up and we're in relationships, but we're not really being fully connected to the present moment. We're not really bringing our full sense of self to the experience. And one of the things about getting more out of life and relationships and possibilities is really practicing how to be mindful. When we have anxiety or insecurities, it might come in the way, but you can do work to help yourself just really be in the present moment without any judgment. Number three is, what are my expectations from others? So do I have a certain expectation from my interactions that I'm having? And my next question was, you know, how can I show up differently to impact my expectations? Meaning, is it possible that I'm wanting people to be loving and accepting to me, but I'm coming across as a little bit demanding? We sometimes don't realize that we impact all of those people around us. We impact our environments, we impact the world. So what are your expectations? And then how can I show up differently to get those met better? And the last question is, what's one boundary that feels vital for setting today? You know, there's so many different boundaries that we might want to get clear on, but there might be something like niggling in your mind, in a love relationship, at a workplace, with your family, with your children, or with yourself, like a self-care boundary, going to sleep by a certain time, taking better care of what you put in your mouth, adding a certain kind of prayer into your day. So what's one boundary that feels vital for today? And my last pointer is that, you know, less is more with boundaries. People will sometimes say, like, what should I say? What words should I use? And I usually, you know, will do more of a mind-body intervention and use more of the somatic kind of exercises to help the person become aware of what boundaries they need. Why? Because when you create shifts in your actions, you're letting people know what your boundaries are, and that's louder. Our actions and our limits that are nonverbal are louder than the words that we use. So yes, you might tell somebody about a boundary you have, or you might just interact in a certain way, but your body sense and your interactions is really the loudest communicator. So here are a few pointers, and I wish you becoming more comfortable embodying the boundaries that you have and living a more meaningful day today.